Hello, good morning students. How are you all? Fine? Okay, good. Yesterday we were studying which poem? What is the name of our poem? The name of our poem is The Try Anti Wonti Gongolope. Anthony Insect. J.S. Dennis, the poet of the poem, is saying that there is a funny insect which you might have never seen. Correct or not? And yesterday the stanza which we saw was which one? It trembles or tickles when we touch it. It trembles means what? It shakes or it moves from one place to another when we touch it. Tickle it means what? When we touch it or we thread upon its toes, if we will keep our feet on its legs or if we will keep our leg on its leg, at that time it will thread means what? It will walk away or then... It will become little, what we call it, will become little frightened, okay. And the last stanza of the poem is left here is, but of course, I will just read for you. The last stanza of the poem is, but of course, you haven't seen it, and I truthfully confess that I haven't seen it either, and I don't know its address. For there isn't such an insect. Though there really might have been. If the trees and grass were purple and the sky was bottle green, it's just a little joke of mine which you will forgive. What is this? You will, okay? Which you will forgive, I hope. Oh, try. Try Auntie Wonty. Try Auntie Wonty Gongolop by C.J. Dennis. Okay? Now, in this poem, poet is saying that in last stanza, poet is saying that, but of course you haven't seen it any time. You might have not seen such type of insect any time, and I have also not seen. But there might be such type of insect somewhere. कुछ तेरी आसल आसा ऐसा type का insect. Okay, who is saying? Poet is saying, and then he is telling that for there isn't such an insect, though there really might have been. असं पण शक्यता अशा टाईपची इन्सेट आहे. आय जस्ट इमॅजिन्ड, आय डी जस्ट डीड इमॅजिनेशन अँड इन माय इमॅजिनेशन आय थॉट दॅट देअर कॅन बी सच टाईप ऑफ इन्सेक्ट, बट देअर कॅन बी सच टाईप ऑफ ॲनिमल्स ऑर इन्सेक्ट्स मोर. हू सेईंग? पोएट इज सेईंग. अँड देन इन लास्ट सेकंड लाईन ही सेईंग दॅट इट जस्ट अ लिटिल हिअर इट इज सेईंग दॅट इफ द ट्रीज अँड ग्रास वर पर्पल. नाव जस्ट इमॅजिन एव्हरीवेअर इट इज ग्रीन. आर यू अंडरस्टँडिंग? Everywhere trees, you see leaves of the trees. Everywhere you see greenery on the earth. Instead of green, if it would be purple, how it would look? It would look more beautiful, yes or no? Because purple is my favorite color. I don't know whether it is your favorite color or not, but then here the poet is saying that if the trees and the grass would be purple and the sky would be bottle green. Poet is saying that if the color of trees and grasses would be purple and if the color of sky would be bottle green, how it would look? Just imagine everywhere purple color. Everywhere you'll just look, see your trees are of purple color, plants are of purple color, grass is of purple color. And that is what, that is imagination, what poet is telling you to do. Are you getting on? And in last he's saying that, oh, it's just a little joke of mine which you will forgive, I hope. Here the poet is saying that I'm just doing a joke. You don't take it seriously because you all are reader. I'm also reader. You are also reader. And poet is saying, Dennis is saying that, oh, it is just a joke. Don't take it seriously. And I think you will forgive me because I have done an imaginative poem. I told you there is such type of, there is a funny insect. It is not like a spider. It is not like a fly. But it looks little bit like a beetle. Okay, and it leaves on the wattle gum. Wattle gum means what? There is a gum on the tree. Some trees are having gum. This funny insect stays on that. It is having which type of nose? It is having snubbish nose. Its face is so funny. Its nose is snubbish. Snubbish means what? Its nose is short and fat. And when you look at it, or if you'll try to touch it, yeah, it will tremble. Correct? No, it will tremble means what? It will shake and move here and there. And it will get frightened of you. It will not allow you to come near. Are you understanding or not? This is the imagination of C.J. Dennis, and he's telling that there can be such type of insects in reality. खरोखर असू शकतात अशा टाइप्सचे इन्सेक्ट्स, बिकॉज इफ विल गो इन फॉरेस्ट, इफ विल गो इन ग्रासलँड्स, यू कॅन सी सच टाईप ऑफ फनी इन्सेक्ट्स. ओके, इन दिस वे वी हॅव कम्प्लिटेड आवर पोएम, अँड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू राईट सेकंड थर्ड, अँड इन थर्ड क्वेश्चन हियर इट इज टोल्ड दॅट फर्स्ट वी विल रीड फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. रीड द पोएम अलाउड यूजिंग प्रॉपर इंटोनेशन, नॉट दॅट वी से इट्स ॲपिटाईट, इट्स मॅनर्स and not its appetite. Are you understanding or not? Apostrophe S is not given. Are you understanding? Here apostrophe S is given. Here also apostrophe S is given. Its means when V-I-T apostrophe S is given at that time, what is meaning of this word? I-T apostrophe S. Meaning of this word is what? I-T, it is. Are you understanding or not? It is. You can see here. Meaning of its is, it is. I-T apostrophe S means what? It is. And its, the word which is not having apostrophe, I-T-S. Meaning of this word is what? Belonging to it. Belonging to someone. Yes or no? We say it is. It's mine. When I'm saying it's mine, that time apostrophe S is not coming. Are you understanding or not? Because something is belonging. For example, if I say this pen, it's mine. At that time, which it's I'm using? ITS. I'm not using IT apostrophe S. IT apostrophe S means what? It is. It is a pen. When I will say it is a pen, means what? It's. Are you getting or not? There are two types of its, IT apostrophe S its and ITS normal its. IT apostrophe S means what? It is. And ITS means what? Belonging to it, belonging to anyone. It's my pen. At that time apostrophe S is not coming, ITS is coming. And if I will say it is a pen, at that time which type of its will be there? IT apostrophe S, it's a pen. Okay, and if I say it belongs to me or it's mine, at that time apostrophe S will not come. Have you understood? Next question. Question number 3 is activity. Is the insect described in the poem a real insect? There is one question. We are going to write down this question in the notebook. Is the insect described in the poem a real insect? Think about an imaginary creature. Describe it in your own words. You may draw its picture and label it. आता काय करायचं इथे तुम्ही? I will give you answer of this question, okay? But you have to think of any another insect. It is your imagination, okay? तुम्ही कल्पना करायची, काल्पनिक, okay? It is काल्पनिक means what? It is imaginative. You have to think and make something funny insect in your mind, okay? And that insect you have to draw in your notebook. And one question is given over there that is the insect described in the poem a real insect? Answer is no. What is answer? No. Question number 3. Answer. No. It is not a real insect. It is not a real insect. And then you have to imagine. You have to imagine any one insect and draw the picture of that insect downside. This is your homework for today, okay? You have to read the poem with good intonation. Here it is told with the proper intonation means what? You will not able to put tune to this poem because this poem is like listen. And you have with correct intonation means ups and downs, where you have to say a little louder, where you have to say a little in low voice. In that way, you have to read the poem, okay? And then you have to complete question number 3, first question. First question's answer I have given you. You have to imagine one creature or you have to imagine any one insect and you have to draw the picture of that insect over here. Understood? In this way, we have completed our poem. If any questions are there in workbook, I will send you photos of those questions and their answers on WhatsApp group today. Okay? Thank you.